Why Shrek is the perfect fit for Fiona? Her parents didn't accept that she had these two sides to her. Shrek always did.
You're pretty, but I like you anyway.
In order to build a marriage that lasts, it requires managing and balancing needs, managing expectations, facing your fears, and embracing the chaos.
It's not my life I'm worried about ruining. It's the kids.
Your fairy tale idea versus the reality, choosing that reality and embracing it with all of its messy parts because you love these people and you want them in your life. Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies.
I'm Alan Seawright. I'm a professional filmmaker who needs therapy.
And today we're going to be...
You pointed at me for a long time.
But I'm not touching you. We're going to be doing movie couples therapy today on Shrek and Fiona. This is actually a part two.
Yeah.
We already did Shrek and Fiona, but that was about dating and courtship. And the next three films are about their married life.
Marriage.
And Shrek 2, 3, and 4 all explore different facets of what it takes to have a long-lasting marriage.
That is true.
Let's dive right in.
Giddy up.
Shrek owns his Shrek own 2. Land. Don't you, honey?
Oh, dealing with yes. The in-laws.
It's in an enchanted forest, abundant in squirrels and cute little duckies and...
What? I know you ain't talking about the swamp.
Donkey.
An ogre from a swamp. Oh, how original.
I always love that donkey just like face plants into the soup there. He says that, talking about having children.
I did the exact same thing.
Early to be thinking about that, isn't it?
Indeed. I just started eating.
Harold.
What's that supposed to mean?
Dad.
John Cleese and Julie Andrews, what casting?
Yes, incredible.
My type. I gotta go to the bathroom.
Dinner is served.
Never mind, I can hold it.
So we're dealing with expectations. Shrek 2 is all about managing expectations in a relationship.
Oh, Mexican food, my favorite.
Well, let's not just sit here with our tummies rumbling.
It's not racist because he's a donkey.
Oh my gosh, Alan! Please rewind it, we can't use that.
Oh, Mexican food! My favorite! Well,
it's not racist because he's a burro.
Stop it! No! Okay, so Fiona's expectations, she let go of them when she married Shrek.
Yeah.
Who she wanted a knight in shining armor. Shrek never expected to be married or fall in love.
No.
So he's just winging it. Fiona's parents definitely had expectations for who she would end up with.
Oh, no. Yep. We usually prefer the ones who've been locked away in a tower.
Disapproving dad, classic.
I love her. Oh, hi. Daycare or Dragon Garden Castle?
You wouldn't understand. You're not her father.
So curiously.
It's so nice to have the family together for dinner.
This kind of weird competitive dynamic I never had with my father-in-law.
Fiona!
Mom! Yeah. Harold!
Donkey!
And this is what happens.
I like that Shrek. You see here, it's a nice character. So he's mad at Shrek, and Shrek is more concerned for Fiona
yep.
than mad at the father-in-law. If we're not careful, we map out our kids' futures.
Yeah.
And we have to leave room for their choices. They are seeing, especially the king, see Shrek in a negative light so that he can still see Fiona in a positive light. He doesn't want to come to terms with, she chose Shrek. She loves Shrek. This is her future. He wants her to be his little girl, and this monster came in and absconded with her. This happens a lot when somebody is brought into the family dating or marriage.
Mm-hmm.
The family wants to maintain good relations, so all the crap gets put on the new person.
Yep.
Not the best.
Join us on our Patreon. People want pictures of my feet. I don't understand the internet. I do understand being in love with Delbert. I know there's dozens of you. Hey, sexy lady, I like your clothes. Ruin shapes in the house of dance. Ruin shapes in the house of dance. That's why we love Jooms Jooms-Jooms-Me. Jooms Germany. Jams Jormy.
Hello,
welcome
there.
To our Q&A.
Yes.
We're going to A, your Qs.
No, you should not do the talking, at least not this early in the
morning. Alan looks like Jason Momoa got zapped with a white mediocrity ray.
And Jonathan looks like the rain.
But remember, dear, if you should ever need me, happiness is just a teardrop away.
Thanks, but we've got all the happiness we need. Happy, happy, happy.
So I see. Let's go, Kyle.
Very nice, Shrek.
What? I told you coming here was a bad idea.
You could have at least tried to get along with my father.
You know, somehow, I don't think I was gonna get Daddy's blessing, even if I did want it.
Well, do you think it might be nice if somebody asked me what I wanted?
Sure.
Valid.
Do you want me to pat for you?
You're unbelievable. You're behaving like a...
Go on, say it.
Like an ogre.
Well, here's a news flash for you. Whether your parents like it or not, I am an ogre!
Ah! And then the hair like goes like...
Princess, that's not about to change.
I've made changes for you, Shrek. Think about that.
She's not wrong. Something that I really like about the writing on this scene... Is it plays into, without highlighting it and saying, this is what we're doing, Shrek's trauma from the first film, which is, they judge me before they really know me.
Yeah.
Right? And so he's triggered by how Fiona's parents are responding to him, especially her father. He's judged before he's known, and this time he's not having any of it. And so he's leading with sarcasm, he's leading with defensiveness. Why? Because he's scared and he's hurt.
Yeah.
And he's so wrapped up in his own pain that he's not thinking about his spouse. He's not thinking about when she says, does anyone want to ask what I want? He's not. He's hurt and he's scared, so he's gone into self-preservation mode. Mm-hmm. Marriage is about balancing needs. It's valid. Shrek needs to feel safe. They've arrived. I don't see Shrek as the bad guy here. He's being mistreated and he's responding from his trauma. He's triggered. But what he needs to do right here is to be vulnerable with Fiona because she has needs. I need to be with my family again. I've been separated from them. I need for us all to get along because we are all family. And Shrek is imposing his will because he's in this emotionally flooded state. I would advise Shrek just to calm the hell down to start because he's not thinking clearly at all. He needs to take some breaths, or more likely, Shrek seems like a catharsis person. He needs
to go hit the bag.
He needs to go hit the bag, He needs to go destroy some stuff or whatever to get all this anger out of him. And then to come back and to say to Fiona, listen, I'm hurt. This is bringing up a lot of stuff for me from how the villagers used to treat me. At the same time, I know this is your family, and it's important to you that this works out. I think we can find a way to balance that. Let's try and find that together. Mm. And instead, I don't think Shrek's a jerk, but out of his pain, he's certainly acting like a jerk.
Yeah.
And on Fiona's side, and I think Fiona's doing a pretty good job of not throwing him under the bus for that. She's just holding him accountable and drawing a boundary. I actually really like Fiona in this scene.
I want what any princess wants. To live happily ever after.
So he's like, kiss me and we can stay like this.
Yep.
With the ogre I married.
It's great that he's...
Happens. I must not cry.
Just let it out, puss.
Cry.
It's great that he's what?
It's great that he's leaning into... I'm willing to change for you permanently. I also just love the design of Shrek as a human. Like, they made him handsome, but he's still a big blocky ogre type handsome guy.
He's still clearly Shrek.
Yeah. Really fun. They didn't just make him a pretty boy.
Which is also why when Charming pretends to be Shrek, like, Fiona never buys it, because she's like, that's not him. But he's willing to change for her. You know, she changed for him before. He's showing that he's willing to meet her on the level of sacrifice she already gave. And it's this dance, right? This balance between accepting one another and growing for one another. And that balance looks different for everyone. But we have to find it. And if it's all growth and change, then there's no safety or belonging.
Now, where were we?
Oh, I remember.
Great job, animators. That little eyebrow raise really sells the line. It's really funny.
Yeah.
He's so fluffy, I'm gonna die!
Why Shrek is the perfect fit for Fiona? Her parents didn't accept that she had these two sides to her. Shrek always did. Temporarily, he puts his pain before her needs in this, but he comes back around in a major way. So... So Shrek 2, balancing needs, managing expectations. Shrek 3, dealing with the pressures and fears of adulthood and specifically parenthood.
Look, having a baby is not going to ruin your life.
It's not my life I'm worried about ruining. It's the kids. I mean, when have you ever heard the phrase, as sweet as an ogre, or as nurturing as an ogre, or how about, you're gonna love my dad. He's a real ogre.
Okay, okay, I get it. Look, nobody said it was gonna be easy. But at least you got us to help you out.
That's true. I'm doomed.
As a guy who... before I got married, and especially before we had kids, I knew I was damaged. I had misdiagnosed what the damage was, and I wasn't aware of the extent to which I was damaged.
Yeah. Yeesh, kebab. That is childhood trauma right there.
What kid is like, oh, you're going to love meeting my dad. He's a real addict. You know, that's not a thing. And I wasn't dealing with it yet. Mm. And I was really, really worried.
Yeah. Because it's one thing to not want children. You don't want children. Don't have children. Easy peasy.
Yeah, great.
Great, valid life choice. It's another thing to want children and to be terrified that you're going to mess them up.
Yes.
And that keeps you from the experience of being a parent, or it leads you to make decisions out of fear, right? Mm-hmm. And the one thing that I will say, and I've said this before on the show, the people who are most likely to actually mess their kids up are the ones who think that they won't.
They think they're going to do it great. Yeah.
Who are just sure that everything they do is going to be amazing. The ones who are afraid of messing their kids up are far less likely to do it because they're constantly assessing and correcting, and they're open to, I did something wrong, so I'm going to be accountable for it. Or I did something hurtful unintentionally, and I'm going to be accountable for it.
Yeah.
And those people tend to just model healthy accountability and that it's okay to be human and make mistakes, right? And so again, if you're like Shrek and you are worried about messing up your kids, odds are you probably won't.
Well, no more than anyone else.
I love meeting people's moms. Like reading an instruction manual as to why they're nuts.
Let's go!
Baby shower.
What is it? He's a live-in babysitter.
Where's the baby?
Oh, you're too kind, Snow, but I can't accept this.
Oh, think nothing of it. I've got 6 more at home.
What does he do?
The cleaning, the feeding.
The burping.
So what are Shrek and I supposed to do?
Well, now you'll have plenty of time to work on your marriage.
Gee, thanks, Rapunzel. And what's that supposed to mean?
Oh, come on now, Fiona. You know what happens.
Huh? You're tired all the time.
Sleeping Beauty.
Stop letting yourself go.
Stretch marks! Say goodbye to romance.
I'm sorry, but... how many of you have kids?
She's right. A baby is only gonna strengthen the love that Shrek and Fiona have. How did Shrek react when you told him? Tell me.
Well, when he first found out, Shrek said...
He didn't react well.
Pretty much that.
He freaked out. Is this human trafficking?
What is it?
It's dwarf trafficking.
So a smaller problem.
Boof.
Ooh. What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard.
When you're dating, spending time together and nurturing the relationship, for a lot of people, it happens organically. It's just natural.
It's just kind of what you do.
Because you're just excited to be in each other's lives, and you're just excited to share time with each other. And so it's just always making things happen and spending this time together. If you transition into marriage, and especially into having kids with that same mindset, it'll just fall off the wayside.
Cause it doesn't come for free anymore.
And it doesn't come, yeah, and it doesn't just happen a lot of the times. I mean, sometimes, but you have to be deliberate about it.
You have to put work in, yeah.
That's the thing is, if you say, well, it's not romantic if we set aside the time for example, for lovemaking, or if we set aside the time for dating, like if it's scheduled, then it's no longer spontaneous. And
if you can't find romance in planned things, you're dumb.
I don't know that you're dumb, but you do have something to learn. Yeah, one of which is you may not be able to be as spontaneous as you'd like to be.
Sure.
Because a lot of your spontaneity is used in your time with your kids.
And the spontaneity is created by your kids.
Yeah, exactly.
You won't have time for spontaneity because they're literally lighting your house on fire.
I'm okay with the events that are unfolding currently.
And I don't think Rapunzel's right about you have time for your marriage.
Right.
You create that time.
Yeah.
And oftentimes it's quality over quantity.
Sure.
Right? Quantity will come later. Right now there's a lot of other things to manage. But as long as you're consistent with it, I mean, the Gottmans talk about in their book, Seven Principles for Making Marriage Work, that even just a 15-minute connection every day.
Super important.
That will do wonders. But speaking of the pressures of married life and parenting,
mm-hmm.
we have what's in our head, this romanticized notion of what we want, and then we have the stressful reality, and that brings us to Shrek Forever After, which I think both of us found to be.
It was quite fun.
Oh, Shrek! Your cake!
So here's Shrek coping with the...
Oh, what is that supposed to be?
That sprinkles the yogurt!
Isn't he cute? He looks just like you!
But happy! It's a party, Shrek!
The reality of it is a lot more stressful, and in his case, he misses being scary and intimidating. But for a lot of us, it's...
How about one of those famous Shrek roars?
Hear the roar!
That kid! That kid!
When he's angry. You don't want to see me angry, do you?
Do it.
Just hold it together.
He's getting away, do something.
What happened to the cake?
I can't get enough of that kid.
You licked it.
But he doesn't feel like the tough, intimidating ogre he used to be. He feels like he's gone soft. And it looks different for different people, but for a lot of men in particular, it's, I miss the glory days of whatever the glory days were.
Yeah.
What?
No, don't cry.
Hey, I believe you promised my son a roar.
Do the roar. I don't like it.
Pegs, we need another cake.
The camera work and editing in this scene to make it frenetic and, oh, it's just great.
Pegs, are there any cupcakes?
Like how sharp the camera moves are.
Lollipops? No, I ate them. What, you didn't share? You didn't share with the croissants!
Everything's gonna be okay.
Well, and that's a thing that is not highlighted enough, is that when you're a parent of children, you have even less patience for adults who act like children.
Yes, absolutely. Yay!
Here, wait.
I love you, Daddy.
The stupidest thing that has ever given me that much joy.
I love you, Daddy.
One of the things that I love about that scene, so I talked about the camera work and the editing and how it really makes it feel frenetic and stuff. I love the sound design on his roar because it's, you know, it's Mike Myers' voice doing a roar, and obviously they did some stuff to pitch it down, but they built in a subharmonic frequency that sounds like an engine winding down.
I heard that, yeah.
And it just, it adds a level of like pathos to a comedy roaring sound.
Yeah.
But you like feel something with it because of what the sound designers did, and just great job.
I think most people who have children, if they're honest about it, have those moments where you don't feel that warm fuzzy. You don't feel that great love and care and consideration. You just feel exhausted and unappreciated and worn out.
Lots of people have that, you know, I was really nervous and worried and whatever. And as soon as I saw you, little baby.
As soon as I held the baby in the arms.
As soon as I held my baby in my arms, I just knew that I was going to love this human forever, more than anything I'd ever.
Oh, the magical transformative moment.
Nothing.
Yeah. Nothing.
Nothing. I had very little feeling, aside from annoyance, for my children for the first year of their lives. Yeah, but literally, what do you do with a baby?
Yeah.
It's a noisy, smelly houseplant.
And they can't even hold their own heads up.
They're it's either crying or nothing.
They just eat and poop, and they cry, and then they cry when they poop.
For some people, there's a very strong paternal, maternal instinct that just kind of kicks in. Like, I don't disbelieve those stories.
Oh, no, I 100% think those are real.
But for some people, it's kind of a learned. The behavior comes before the feeling.
Yeah.
Where you show love, and the more you show love, the more the feeling of love starts to... Because now you've got, you know, you've got a baby. You've got to be a dad to this baby.
Right.
And you change diapers and you calm it and you comfort it. And the more you do it, the more the feeling of love starts to increase, right? So Shrek has this journey with Rumpelstiltskin that's kind of like it's a Wonderful Life, except for it's not had I never been born, it's had Fiona and I never gotten together. Like, what would life be like for everybody? And Shrek Forever After, if you haven't seen it, it's actually pretty cool.
It's pretty good.
But Shrek has this experience of coming to appreciate what his life is. The notion of choosing your love and then loving your choice is... It's gonna suck sometimes.
Yeah.
Like, your happily ever after is gonna have suckiness to it.
Yeah.
It's gonna have people crying.
It's a happily ever after on balance.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
It's happy in the aggregate.
Yep.
But like moment to moment, there's chaos. So Shrek comes back and... This is after he's had his adventure.
He's gone through his whole journey and he gets reset to this time.
Because what we didn't see...
I love you, Daddy.
Is Shrek got mad and stormed out of there the first time.
Yep.
And has a fight with Fiona.
Everybody, I have found another cake!
Shrek, are you okay?
And he thought of life without her and the children.
Fiona.
And he experienced it.
I've never been better. Happy birthday, Farkle. Fergus, my little man.
They are super cute animated ogre babies.
Yep.
I believe this is yours.
Thank you, Daddy.
Aww.
Aww.
Hey, Uncle Shrek, how about giving my babies an encore?
Please, senor, let us have
I didn't know we could do that.
That's my best friend!
You know, I always thought that I rescued you from the Dragon's Keep.
You did?
No. It was you that rescued me.
Aww.
From the dog pound.
I mean, it's a tad disappointing that the Shrek films ultimately kind of become the schmaltz they were roasting so effectively in the first film.
Until now you have become the very thing you swore to destroy.
But where else do you go?
But it's still touching and it's still beautiful. And
it's lovely.
Look, in order to build a marriage that lasts, it requires managing and balancing needs.
Yep.
Managing expectations. Facing your fears when it comes to parenting and life and responsibility, and embracing, I'm not saying fully embracing the chaos, by all means.
Try to rein it in.
Try and rein it in and have some order in your life. Mm-hmm. But recognizing that your fairy tale idea versus the reality, choosing that reality and embracing it with all of its messy parts, with all of its unpleasant parts, because you love these people and you want them in your life.
Yeah, look, 5 minutes from now, these kids are going to be running around all sugared up.
Oh, yeah.
You know, playing with their new toys and, like, bonking people on the knee and whatever. Like, it's going to be a shit show again.
Yep. But hopefully it's a shit show that he manages and enjoys
yep.
better than before. Rock on. So until next time.
Do the roar.
I love you, Daddy.
And
watch movies.
Pass me the corn on the cob, Daddy. Buy me a Twinkie.
Daddy, we want to thank our patrons. People like...
Piper Pine.
Amanda Mannix-Spellmeyer.
Robert M. Hammer.
Do the voice. Do it. Meredith Webb. Do it.
Kathleen Estes.
I love you, Daddy.
Don't call me Daddy.
At least
the patrons are our real daddies.
Oh my gosh, yes.
Sugar daddies. Anyway, support us on Patreon. It's awesome. Yay. Woo. Patreon.
Super fun. Happy times.